As you saw, this is my sister's house, and I was thinking, and I want to share that the anticipation of getting ready the Christmas tree was already too much pressure for me during the past week. And I don't know, I don't remember seeing, no cierto, Alan?
What?
I don't remember any other year of people already decorating their homes so early in the year.
Yeah.
Is it spicy?
I am so happy that we already have the Christmas tree, like you have no idea.
I know, okay? Me too. Mm-hmm. And I had a lot of fun decorating it with you.
I will learn how to prepare that delicious soup and share it with you all in my next videos. And because we ate a lot, we are going to be having papaya juice for dinner, and I'm going to be sharing. And right now, Alan is studying because he has a test tomorrow. I'm going to make papaya juice, Alan.
Sounds good.
Right now, okay. So these are the ingredients that you will need. Here you have the onion, butter, cranberries, and then here you have sugar, two oranges, organic ketchup, and pomegranate juice, brown sugar, and I got this chicken, which is breast strips. Leave it in water for a few minutes. Good morning. About to prepare a delicious cranberry sauce. As you can see, I already have all the cranberries in water, and I'm going to show you step by step how to make this delicious cranberry sauce. So if you don't know how to cook this, maybe you will want to share it in Christmas, no? For Christmas dinner. So let me start. Just one more quick rinse. Make sure that all of them are good, okay? That you don't have nothing there that it can be smashed like this. You don't want that, so all of them has to be like these ones. Perfect. So I turn on the stove, and while this is getting hot, I'm now going to squeeze two oranges, and I'm going to put the juice right away in there. See, by the time that you are finished with the juice, this is already like starting to boil a little bit, and that's when you now put the juice. Now you will add half cup of sugar and half a cup of brown sugar. Now you will mix it. And now you will add a little bit of pomegranate, more or less that amount. Some people just put a shot, but I just want to put a little bit more than that. So just... And now you will add a little bit of kosher salt, okay? Just a little bit. And now you cover it and leave it for 20 minutes on medium high. Okay, so while the cranberry sauce is being cooked, I'm going to show you how to prepare the chicken. So I'm going to put butter first on the pan. You don't know how good this kitchen smells right now. It's super good. I have like another hour before going to pick up my son at school. So for butter, I'm going to use a full spoon. You can use as much as you want. melted. Okay, now that this is melted, we are going to get the onion ready in there. This is getting ready. You see, it's, I love the smell. It's super nice. But look, completely delicious. I'm going to try it. I have to try this. I can't believe that I'm cooking this. So simple. Mm. Alan will love this when he comes after school. And my niece too. I cannot wait to give it to her because she likes sweets more than my son. My son doesn't like sweets too much. But this cranberry and gnocchi will love it because it has like a little bit of sour flavor too. Sweet and sour, so super good. Okay, so this is ready. I'm gonna cover it. Turn off the stove. And now that you saw that the onion is in the pan, I'm going to now throw the chicken. But before, I wanted to tell you something about this sauce. Here I wanna show you the chicken and let me put this in higher. I'm sorry, I make videos usually when my son is at school in the morning and I have only 6 hours to do a million things like Wonder Woman before he gets out of school. So I'm sorry if my idea sometimes comes and goes and doesn't come back. I'm trying to remember everything that I want to share. So I'm so sorry, I don't know what I was saying, but I think that I wanted to say, oh yeah. Like this sauce, once it gets cold, you take it out of the pan, you put it on in a bowl, and then leave it on the fridge for one full day. And for what I hear, it tastes a lot better if you do it that way. But right now, because I'm cooking this chicken, my son, I like it just like I try it, like I told you. Okay, so the onions are ready and boiling, so I'm going to throw the chicken inside. I'm recording myself with one hand, so excuse me if it doesn't look super nice. you will also need 3 spoons of white vinegar. I almost forgot about that ingredient. Okay, you're going to add the ketchup. Mix it all. Excellent, this dish. Okay, and then I'm going to use this white vinegar, 3 tablespoons. So, let me see. Well, more or less 3 tablespoons. I'm just, I'm busy. I'm just not gonna use a spoon, I'm just gonna use it like that. But I'm telling you the exact measurement is 3 tablespoons. I'm just gonna use it like this. That's enough. And you will need 3 tablespoons of the cranberry sauce. Look at this. Look the consistency of this cranberry sauce. So it's perfect. Now mix it. Oh, I forgot the salt. Wait, I'm gonna use kosher salt. Okay, now that this is boiling, you are going to put it on medium low for 20 minutes. And it's gonna be the perfect timing before I have to go and pick up my son at school.
looks good.